We wish to apologise to the Australian Rugby League Commission, all of the NRL, for creating negative news, shifting the spotlight from the launch of the Women in League round.
The cause of all the trouble? These rainbow stripes. Seven Seagulls stars preferring to miss a potentially season-defining clash against the Roosters than wear the club's pride jersey.
They are not wearing the jersey as it conflicts with their cultural and religious beliefs. The players will not play on Thursday, and we accept their decision.
The club's attempt to promote diversity and inclusion somehow failing to include the playing group itself ahead of yesterday's launch.
None of the coaching staff nor the players had prior knowledge to the jersey. They should have been consulted.
But even Daly Cherry Evans was blindsided by the strength of his teammates' objections.
Stuff like this isn't a topic of conversation unless put in the situation, so we're experiencing a lot of things for the first time as a playing group.
In a situation with no real winners, the club captain, the league boss, even the PM, all looking to locate a silver lining.
It's a really good initiative, and I think it's going to be 17 people out there that are going to do a lot of people proud and hopefully make some people that are feeling at home a little bit vulnerable, hopefully feel a little bit more welcomed in society.
They are no different. And for anyone that wants to make them different, I feel sorry for them, because we are all the same.
It's important that in Australian society, we respect everyone for who they are.
But when the rights of respective groups come into conflict, inclusion's easier said than done, something Manly's found out the hard way.
Our intent was to be caring and compassionate towards all diverse groups. Instead of enhancing tolerance and acceptance, we may have hindered this. This was the opposite of our intent.
Oh, well, Manly great Ian Roberts was the first and still the only league player to come out while playing, and he joins us now to chat through this. A huge day. How did you feel when you saw those players refusing to wear the jersey?
I think first and foremost, the Manly club, Des Hasler and Daly Cherry Evans and the team, it needs to be acknowledged that, you know, that they've owned the mistakes that were made. I think that, you know, we need to respect that. You know, we also need to respect those seven players and their decision, you know, for religious reasons or cultural reasons. Obviously, Pride Round is all about inclusion and diversity and welcoming. Creating an atmosphere of making the LGBTIQ plus people in this community feel worthy, you know. It was disappointing, but I've got to be honest, you know, I was surprised this pushback didn't come earlier.
Oh, it's interesting that you say that. I know there's so many dimensions to this, and we'll try to get through a few of them if we can. One of them, though, that you kind of referenced is the process of it. I understand you knew about the jumper a while ago, like a month ago. The players don't seem to have known, and so there is a consultation dimension to that. That's obviously not good process, but do you think it made any difference? Would they have been more likely to jump on board if they were consulted?
It was definitely a breakdown of communication, obviously. I don't know what the players' reaction would have been if they'd known a month ago, if their decisions would have been different, but at least they would have had the opportunity to speak up sooner and voice their opinion. And we need to respect that. You know, like I said, you know, there needs to be a respectful conversation here from both sides. We can't vilify any of these players. Their right to refuse to play, you know, should be respected as well.
Ian, is it actually possible to reconcile the two sides of this? Because on the one hand, we've got these conservative religious groups, we've got LGBTQI rights, which are really important, but they just seem at odds with each other. Where do we go in terms of reconciliation?
That's a $64 million question right there. You know, we need to have a conversation. You know, this conversation, you know, like, this is the first Pride round that the NRL, any of the NRL clubs, we're going to hold. Obviously, it could have been done better, and we learn from that now, you know, but it's a conversation starter if nothing else. Yes, we need to be able to sit around a table and talk about this, and it needs to be, I keep saying, it needs to be a respectful conversation, and we need to respect other people's, you know, views and beliefs.
Ian, as we mentioned before, you're still the only active NRL player to come out. In this context, what would you say to a current player who is thinking about doing the same thing?
You know, it's such a personal thing when someone comes out. That person, you know, they need to feel safe. And they're in a safe environment. They need to feel welcomed. It's for any person coming out, that's the biggest obstacle. I mean, I think what's happened, particularly now that those players are not playing, it does, you know, unfortunately, it does send a bit of a message. Mm. You know, I feel for all those kids out in the suburbs who are dealing with sexuality issues or sexual identity. You know, a lot of those kids would be feeling a little bit less today.
Mm. Well, Ian, we appreciate you coming on tonight and talking us through it. It's been a tricky day, I'm sure, for you, but thank you so much for your time.
I appreciate that. Could I just send out a special hello to Anthony Albanese for talking about this issue today and bringing it a bit of air. I think, you know, it's encouraging that the government are aware that this is a conversation that needs to be had.
Noted. Thank you so much for joining us and really graciously having me.